Good day, coffee gang. Adam from Cafe Kendama here. Today we are going to be looking at what it means to be sponsored by a Kendama company. What is sponsorship and why is it so important to everybody? The benefits of being sponsored and why I don't want to be sponsored, all from the perspective of an influencer marketing specialist. Now, why am I the guy to talk about this? Well, A, I am an influencer marketing specialist. Outside of Kendama, I run a successful influencer marketing program that's been featured by Yotpo, and we have done over $10,000 a month in spend profitably on influencer marketing and continue to bring in a consistent revenue with our company doing that. Additionally, I've also interviewed virtually every major Kendama brand owner on what they look for in their sponsored players and why it's beneficial to them as a brand. We're going to be breaking this down into what does it mean to be sponsored from a brand's perspective, first off. Secondly, what are the benefits that you get as a player for a company? So stick around and we are going to be diving into these questions. First off, we need to ask the question, what is sponsorship? Because sponsorship is not a one-size-fits-all. There are multiple different types of sponsorship. In the Kendama community, we have pro-sponsored players like Alex Mitchell, and we have Flow team members on different companies. Chrome has different team members. They have ambassadors. We got Kendama France. There are so many brands, and they all have different ways of doing their sponsorship program. Now, we're not going to talk about every single brand and what their program looks like and how you can get sponsored by the brand that you want to get sponsored by, but today I want to talk about the overarching picture of what sponsorship is from a business's perspective. First, we need to understand that there are different types of sponsorship and different types of influencer marketing in general. At the company I work for, we have a few different tiers of sponsorship that we work for or work with. First off, we have affiliates that we work with where we give them a coupon code or an affiliate link that whenever one of their audience members clicks through the link and purchases a product off our website or uses their discount code, they receive a commission. And so that means if you were to sell $100 worth of product through your link, that you would get paid $10 for it, which isn't bad. You know, that's what every major YouTuber does in their description of their YouTube channels is they include affiliate links, and that's one of the ways that they generate an income. Second to that, there are product for promo sponsorships. What does that mean? That means that I might want to send you a Kendama as a brand owner so that you can play with it and post clips with it and hopefully tag the company and just show off that me as a generous company decided to send you a Kendama for free so that you can play with it. Now, don't be deceived, but also don't overthink it. Sometimes Kendama companies just want to be very giving and show their love, but the benefit to that is that that's great PR for the company. That is another opportunity for them to reach into another community because you have an audience that you get to share through, and ultimately they hope that that produces a positive return on investment for them. Thirdly, there are paid promotions. Now, these paid posts usually have a direct correlation to a return on investment. If I'm paying someone to do a post for us, I want to give them a coupon code to share so that way I can track the sales that they're doing. Sometimes that's not the case. Sometimes they just want awareness. Generally, we want to track the return on that investment. We write out a contract with them if it's a big influencer and we're doing multiple posts, or if it's a one-time thing, sometimes that's through Instagram DMs. Now, from my knowledge, there aren't very many Kendama companies that do this. However, there are stories of other brands outside of Kendama reaching out to Kendama players to do paid posts for them to help grow their brand. And this is oftentimes another skill toy or another product kind of adjacent to the Kendama community. Fourthly, there is another type of sponsorship called the stakeholder partnership. Now, generally, this means that there is a product made by that company that is branded in the influencer's name or in their design, and they would receive a royalty every time that product is sold. Generally speaking, that is a pro mod in the Kendama community, and for most companies, they would include some sort of royalty with that. So every time you purchase a pro mod of your favorite pro, that pro is receiving a small kickback on the cost of that Kendama. So if the Kendama is worth $50, they might get a 3% royalty and they would receive a small amount of money every time that Kendama is sold. This is a great opportunity for you to receive some residual income and just get your name out there. It is such an honor to have a Kendama made in your name. But that would be called the stakeholder type of partnership, or at least that's the language that I generally will use for it. In Kendama, we see a couple of these different types of sponsorships, as well as we see a combination of them, from affiliate links to paid posts to product for promo, stakeholder, you name it. And in Kendama, we have such amazing companies that do such amazing sponsorships for their players on their team. So these are the different types of sponsorships that exist out there, and every company runs it a little bit different. So if you are trying to grind and hustle for a sponsorship with your favorite company, it might be in your best interest to ask yourself, you know, what kind of sponsorship would I even want if I were gonna get one? Is all you want just product? Do you want to be paid for the work that you do for that company? You have to ask yourself those questions. Now, in Kendama, most of us aren't about the money. We just love playing ball in the cup so much that we are willing to just do it regardless, and we share about our favorite brands all the time anyways. So with that said, you can make that decision for yourself what you want out of Kendama, but I wanted to break down for you the different types of sponsorships that do exist from an influencer marketing standpoint, and for you to recognize that for a brand, it is about return on investment. With that understanding, let's talk about the benefits for you to be sponsored. First off, there are a lot of benefits to being sponsored as a player in the community. One is if you're looking to grow your influence, you obviously want to be sponsored because you are getting access to a bigger platform than yourself. You know, if I was sponsored by the company Soul Kendamas, they have a much larger Instagram page than me, and the benefit would be is that they would be repping me just as much as I would be repping them, hopefully. They might be sharing my posts more regularly on their feed, and I might be getting some free swag from them, like some new Kendamas, maybe some clothing. You name it, I could be getting a lot of these things, and these are all some of the benefits I might get. More than that, some of the things that are intangible is that I get authority. We look up to sponsored players. We see them as the heralds of our community, the people that really put the community on their back, and they are great representatives that hold us together. They are the ones that are often hosting jams, running events, and coordinating the growth of Kendama. And with a brand behind you, that gives you so much opportunity to do more of that and for you to be a driving force of change in the Kendama community. And I think that in itself is a great honor. To be able to work with a brand and have that brand come alongside you and behind you to help elevate the Kendama community, that is so. Thirdly and lastly in this category, clout. Clout is cool. We all make fun of it, but seriously, we love being looked up to as human beings. We love having influence. Maybe not everybody, but generally speaking, it's kind of cool to have people follow us. And it's a privilege, absolutely, and it's one not to be taken lightly, but it's one that is generally desired. We like to be looked up to as humans, and that is okay as long as we don't let it get to our ego. So those are some of the benefits. And when most people think of being sponsored in the Kendama community, we are thinking about getting boxes of Kendama sent to us, being paid to go to events, and receiving, you know, a pro mod at some point in our sponsorship journey. Now that's all said and true, and that is accessible for us, and that can happen with certain companies and sponsorships, and definitely is an opportunity. However, that isn't the only thing that comes with it, and I like to make sure that we see that there's a bigger picture. So, boiling all of that down, why do companies sponsor Kendama players? Well, they get increased PR. They get a face to represent their brand to a broader community. They're getting access to content for resharing purposes. Your clips, your tricks are just as much for your own benefit as they are for the company's benefit. Especially if you're a top tier player posting banger tricks on their Kendama, they want to show that their Kendama is really good at doing tricks. And so for them to have a constant stream of content coming in from their influencers, from their sponsored players, is a great asset to the company and that increased awareness of their brand. And so if you are fortunate enough to get a Kendama sent to you for free, generally that company, whether or not they expect it or not, hopes or at least crosses their fingers that you are going to post and that you should take that seriously because they are probably looking at you as a sponsored player. You might want to be sponsored. And here's my recommendations in a few quick steps. One, if you want to be sponsored, focus on value. Focus on generating value for a brand and for the community in specific. Don't focus so much on being the best at doing tricks, though that is important, and there generally is a baseline of skill that you must pass in order to be sponsored. So focus on being good at Kendama, for sure, but primarily focus on being a value-giving individual in the Kendama community. If you first give value to the community, that company is going to see you as a titan, as a herald of the game itself, and they are going to want to make sure that you are representing their brand, because you are someone who is leading change, and if that change can include that brand's logo or that brand's Kendamas, that is an opportunity for them to get a positive return on investment. I get the wonderful opportunity to represent a lot of different brands on the podcast, and this is a very value-giving platform, I believe, and I'm excited to be able to represent a lot of different brands and in some ways be sponsored by a lot of different brands. I get a lot of love from virtually every major company. I've been reshared by them all. I've had their major owners on. I've gotten more free Kendama sent to me this year than I've ever gotten in my life before me. And I've had some incredible privileges to have some incredible conversations with the people I really look up to in the Kendama community that have been sponsored, that have been playing the game for much longer than me. And it was because I focused on creating a platform that was value-giving. When you do good, or when you put value up first, you will receive value in return. If you just do good to others, good will come back to you. So my recommendation to you is find a unique way to add value to the people around you. Don't be selfish. Don't be looking for that sponsorship. Don't message companies saying, you should sponsor me. Because generally, companies will be the first to reach out to someone that they want to sponsor. Very seldom does it ever pan out in your favor to DM a company saying, sponsor me, homie. That would be great. Don't do that. Don't be a Grom. That's called being a Grom. Post more content. Create content that is reshareable. If you create content that is easily accessible, brands themselves to repurpose and to reshare, that is a wonderful opportunity. To get reposted on a company's page is like a gateway to being sponsored. It's an opportunity for you to get your foot in the door, to be known. So think about the brand that you want to represent or that you might want to be sponsored by and create content that fits their narrative. What kind of company are they trying to be? What are they doing in the Kendama community that is so different than the other brands? And how can you be a part of pushing that forward? Maybe that's by creating YouTube content surrounding that company, or creating YouTube content that helps build that company higher, or creating an Instagram post that is more than just you posting another clip with their trip. Maybe that's going on your stories. Maybe that's sharing that brand to other people and pointing people to that brand. Who knows what it is? You do. And you probably have an idea in your head already of what that could look like. So my recommendation to you guys is go and create wonderful value-giving content and focus on just having fun. Ask yourself the question, do you want to be sponsored? And ask yourself why. Why do you want to be sponsored? Is it because you want free stuff or because you want to have more of a platform to grow the game? If you want to have a platform to grow the game itself, that is a better mindset to have going into sponsorship, because that is what's going to fuel you. Having a brand behind you gives you a lot more authority to be able to run events, to bring people together, but you need to be first a sponsorable person. Thanks guys, and we will catch you in the next episode.